pattern?
Not yet.
Spray.
Yes, sir, right away, sir.
Mr. Spray!
That's it! Fish open, canceled. What? Move it out! Get it! Got all
do
the
I look like
you're talking about!
Hey, what's going on? Hello, Ponder!
You're out of here! Take that hat back!
No, what are you doing? No, what's going on here? We're trying to film a show here!
Canceled.
How did it cancel?
You are so like this show! We're gonna do a family show!
We just started that set!
Quality control and our research has shown that we only do that our viewers only like family shows.
Well, I see the damn Russians invaded New York again. Where's the damn comics?
What would you like for breakfast, dear?
How about food for a change? Something edible for once?
Dear, how would you like your eggs?
Cooked, and I'd like them put on a plate and set in front of me for consumption.
Of course, anything you say, dear.
And stop arguing with me, you disagreeable wench. You women are all alike, always looking for a fight. If I had the right, I would strangle each and every one of you smarmy tarts, and there's not a jury in the world that would convict me. And furthermore, if another one of those equity women runs for public office, I say we dissect her female parts, put them in a bag, and throw them in East River.
That's nice, dear.
Oh, if I was running this country.
Hi, dear.
I'm up to my Lamar's class.
Oh, dear, I didn't realize you were pregnant.
I'm not, but I'm practicing.
Well, don't stay out too late.
Goodbye, Dad.
Yeah, sure, Mom. Goodbye, you. Who is that?
Why, silly, that was your daughter.
Daughter? I don't have a daughter.
Of course you do.
No, I don't. I'm not even married.
You are so dear to me.
I am not.
We've been married for 20 glorious years.
You're a loony tune. I would remember being married to you my whole life.
I've been with you your entire life.
You think I would remember being stuck with somebody like you?
We've been happily married for 22 and a half glorious years.
Yeah, prove it.
Here is a photo of our wedding day.
No, prove we've been happy.
Don't be facetious now.
This photo could have been doctored.
This is our marriage license.
Let me see that. Yeah. Here do. Bonds of holy matrimony, Miss Nora Fishbait and Mr. Ralph Bloomer. How do I know that's you? And how do I know that's me? Oh, good. I'll keep these for... and examine them later.
Oh, no, last time you got your hands on these, you doused them in gasoline and was feverishly trying to strike a match.
All right. You may be my wife, but there is no way that is my kid.
Hello, Mother. Hello, Potter.
Oh, God, another one.
Well, I've got a gosh golly good day planned with Mary Mae Thorndecker. And if it's not too much of an inconvenience, I was wondering if I could borrow the estate for the weekend from you adoring parents.
Of course, dear. Anything your little heart desires. Isn't that right, Father?
Oh, yeah. Okay, sure.
Well, if I'm not just the luckiest son of a gun, I don't know who is. Well, toodaloo, I'm off to Ascot.
What was that?
Why, silly, that was your only son, your pride and joy.
As a twittering songbird, you might be my wife. And that lumbering gazelle might be my daughter. But there is no way that prancing fruitcake is my son.
But you love him so. You wept the day he was brought home from the hospital.
I'm still weeping.
Nobody move. I'm with the government.
Oh, how lovely company for breakfast.
Please, don't make any sudden movements, lady, or I'll let you have it.
Give it to her.
Would you like some coffee?
I am Chief Inspector Axon Sneed. I am with the Government Family Removal Program, a highly security but highly financed operation that is neither CIA nor FBI, but is 10 times more secretive than anything old Ollie North could ever muster up. The air mission here is twofold. To secure the shores of these here great United States from subversive elements attempting to interweave themselves into the fabric of American society.
How would you like your eggs?
You, Mr. Ralph Bloomers?
Damn right.
Sir, I'm afraid to inform you that these people are not members of your family.
You don't say.
Nope. These are people that are attempting to infiltrate themselves into suburban living. But don't worry, we're on top of it. The kids are all locked up into the paddy wagon. This is the last of them. Come along with me, madam.
But my eggs are burning!
I have a gun, and I'll use it if I want to.
Go ahead, give it to her. I knew I didn't have a family. Pass the funny.
Hello? I'm Ronald Greensleeve, president of Cable Access Channel 99, and this is my mustache. You know, it's come to my attention that recently a show called
Lowbrow Theatre
has been appearing on my airwaves. Well, this is a show that thumbs its nose at society, flaunts itself at every opportunity, indulges in a lowbrow, demeaning manner, and generally behaves quite silly. Well, there's no place on television for this, not even on cable, but I will not put up with a show that exhibits a blatant disrespect for authority and acts in a childish and immature fashion. I apologize for this show, and I will see to it that I'll put a stop to its style of second-rate burlesque humor, and I'll put a stop to it immediately. I'm Ronald Brownsleeve, and you have my word for it.
Oh, welcome, welcome to my establishment. Thank you both for coming to the PC Cafe. Please, everything here is for your pleasure here.
I hope so.
May I take you to a table here?
That would be nice.
The best table we have. Follow me, please, please. Oh, this way, folks, this way, please, please. Right here. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. This is our finest window seat.
Oh, you know what? The sun is too bright here.
Yes, you're right. We don't like the window seat. Way too bright. Please, please, follow me. This way. Yes, right over here. Yes. Here we go. The table for your meal of your dreams here, which I'm sure you will all enjoy. Yes.
You know, I specifically asked for non-smoking.
Yes, you did. My fault. I should have known since you didn't ask for it. Yes. Okay, come, quick. We shall go to the non-smoking, non-window area. Right this way. Here we go, folks. Here we go. So sorry about all the inconvenience. Here, please. The non-smoking, non-window area. I'm sure this will be to yours.
You know what? The music is really too loud here. There's no way I'm going to be able to carry on a conversation.
Yes, you're so right. What is wrong with me? My God, come. We shall go to the non-vocal area. Please, please. Here we go, folks. I am sure that this here will come to your pleasure. No music, no smoking, no surgery. Everything's to your pleasure.
Do I have to sit here and listen to this baby cry all night?
Yes, yes, of course. What was I thinking? Come, I'll take you to the non-procreative area. Come, 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 come. This, folks, will be exactly to your taste. I know, I know, I know.
They're eating meat over there.
Right, the vegetarian area. Come, let's go, let's go. Okay, so here we are at the non-smoking, non-scenic, non-vocal, non-procreating area. I'm sure you'll enjoy this table.
You serve alcohol here?
Right, I'll take you to the non-alcoholic area. Come, come.
Here you go, madam. This is our finest table here. This is reserved for the president of Madagascar when he's in town.
I can't sit by the kitchen. Staff coming
right
in and out.
It's 10 minutes after the hour, and this is Newsbreak. The man who discovered the cure for the common cold, Dr. Wally Zink, was among those nominated this week for a Nobel Award in scientific achievement for his other research work, conversing with tree squirrels. A Lake Wahoo couple are suing the Wahoo School District for allegedly teaching their child to sing and talk only in prose. This is the fourth such class action suit that's been brought against the school district this year. And an unidentified man went on a rampage in downtown Minneapolis last night, assaulting several mailboxes and quite a few hydrants. He was finally apprehended by police while attempting to make love to the IDS building. It's now 12 minutes after the hour, and this has been Newsbreak.
In the Middle East, tensions are once again high as Iraqi strongman Saddam Hussein has recommenced his persecution of the Kurds in northern Iraq. Despite repeated warnings by the United States to cease at once, Saddam has continued his assault of his own people, this time by such means as harassment, torture, extermination, and having to sit through a Pauly Shore film festival. And the first of three scheduled debates between the leading candidates for the U.S. Senate seat was held last night at Northrop Hall. After a productive start, it quickly degenerated into a nasty name-calling affair, which resulted into hair-pulling, eye-gouging, and finally the TPing of each candidate's home. It was mandated that there will be no follow-up debates. It's now 14 minutes after the hour, and this has been Newsbreak.
It's still 14 minutes after the hour, and this is Newsbreak. City fathers have disclosed plans for the latest downtown development proposal. During a lavish press reception at the mayor's office, the architectural firm of Sis, Boom, and Ba unveiled plans that include buildings no taller than 12 inches high, mushroom fields, and a winding road made entirely of yellow bricks. With the additional name change to Munchkin Land, one city council member was quoted as saying, "This'll bring them downtown." A series of unconfirmed sightings around town have convinced some Twin Cities residents that they have seen God hitchhiking on Highway 10. When asked to clarify why they believed it was God, they all responded by saying he wore very nice shoes. It's now 16 minutes after the hour, and this was Newsbreak.
It's 16 minutes after the hour, and we are back with Newsbreak. Startling news as NASA scientists confirm that life once did exist on Mars. But after further examination, it was revealed that without fast food restaurants and cable TV, it wasn't much of a life.
Major traffic delays have hit motorists on southbound 35W during rush hour today as construction was backed up for miles trying to get by the construction of a small sandcastle. MnDOT warns that it is sandcastle construction season, so please expect delays. Meanwhile, continual griping is being heard about the westbound Seine lane on 394 being used for playing hopscotch.
Oh. Breaking news just in. The hole in the ozone layer has grown to the size of Australia, and state officials advise all people to stay inside their homes for the next 2,000 years and drink plenty of orange juice.
No new developments in the mad cow disease, although there has been a breakthrough with an irritated calf. This news just in! Three people
are still 15 minutes past the hour! And now we take a break.
This just in, there has been a double homicide committed in the studios of Channel 99. Both assailants are reported dead. Police are on their way. Details are sketchy at present, but we'll keep you updated on this story on our next news break.
Yes, sir. Can I help you?
I want to buy a gun.
Any particular make in mind?
No.
Any style?
No.
Any brand name?
No.
Any caliber?
I want a gun. A gun that shoots bullets.
Ah, well, I'm sure you'll find that most of our selections will accommodate you, sir. Now, this is a nifty little number.
Oh, I'll take that one.
This is an excellent choice, sir. It's a 38 Luger, and it
I'll take this one right here.
Very good choice, sir. And you sure what? Are into the hard sell, aren't you?
I want some bullets, too.
These are aluminum-tipped copper casing bullets that are guaranteed...
Don't wrap it. I'll take it with me.
Sir, as a formality, I believe I must see your gun permit.
Permit. Permanent. Permanent.
Yes, any moment now. Thank you. Sir... This is actually a note from your mother.
Yes?
Dear sirs, this is to permit Malcolm, that's you, to purchase a gun with my permission. Uh-huh. Sincerely, Mrs. Haberdashery. Well, looks just fine to me, and you may now purchase your gun.
Thank you.
Hold it! That's it! You're canceled! Stop that program! I will not have this kind of stuff on the air. As a TV executive, it's my responsibility to see that responsible stuff like gun control is not made fun of. I mean, I don't think I could sleep at night if I knew that little Johnny had gotten hold of his parents' World War II collection of bazookas and blew a hole through Grandpa's shed with Grandpa still in it. No, I just couldn't take it. So, off you go. Miss Hotlegs, have you sent my check to the NRA yet? Well, get on it, woman! Come on! They're dangerous. They got guns, you know. All right, now let's see a little more family entertainment.
Coming this fall, the epic miniseries that everyone's been talking about. Thrills galore. Excitement tenfold. Bloodshed unsurpassed. The most ambitious, expensive miniseries ever produced before. See Vikings for dinner. October for 18th straight night, only in chapter 9.
Shows. Canceled. Oh, this one. Canceled. Ah, here we go. The Monday lineup. Canceled. 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 Wednesday through Friday. Canceled. Canceled.
illuminated by only the moon.
Nah, too dark.
And a 60-watt bulb. Suddenly, figures appeared, past as dark as the room.
Who's there?
Mary?
John!
Mary!
John!
Mary!
John!
Mary!
John! John! I thought you'd never come!
Oh, I had to come. Despite our differences. I know our families hate each other, with the lawsuit and all. And you being a lawyer, and me being a window washer, it's just not gonna work. You know? Maybe... I know you make a lot of money, and I just...
Oh, but John, what does that mean in the grand scheme of things? The planets, the cosmos, ping-ponging around our psyches, the atoms bouncing off each other. And no matter what happens in this vast universe, there's still this uncontrollable post-nasal drip.
Nah, too intellectual.
Oh, Pookie Wookie, I have something for you.
What is it, sweetie Petey?
Straight from the bottom of my heart to yours.
Oh, Georgie Porgy! Petunia's my favorite! Thank you.
I thought you really liked it.
Nah. Too sappy.
Hey, hot legs. I got something for you.
Yeah? What is it, pencil neck?
Say your prayers.
Oh, yeah? Where is it? Where's the money? I knew you were going to take the money. Get up here. Where is the money? I'm only going to ask you once.
Nah, too violent.
Spit it out, lady. We knew where you were there. We saw you at the scene of the crime. The body was there, but there was no murder weapon. What did you do with it?
Well, this is how it happened. I was at Dayton's, and I was shopping, and I couldn't find anything. So
that's not going to be.
Well, I decided I'd go to Saks. So I tried to get a cab, but
Saks, I bet you hid the body parts and the weapon in the garbage.
I got in this line. All these people were in front of me, and they were all crowding into these taxis, and then the taxis disappeared.
Crowding into the taxis?
They were all gone.
Everybody was gone. We were out on the coast of Finland one time. We got crushed by a big old tidal wave, came across the whole boat of the men, and wiped out my whole army. And we couldn't get the Norway invasion going on, but we got these really nice
taxis. I'll get you, my pretty!
Might be a little too avant-garde. real. The movies would never take it. No, no book publisher would take that. Hey! They'll be perfect for television. Hey, you're canceled. You're canceled. Operator, you're canceled. Bill Gates, canceled. Canceled, canceled, canceled. Hey, this is me. Good Lord, I've canceled myself. This is the 5 p.m. news. I'm Miles Underwood. We open our newscast on a sad note. We have just got word of a tragic work-related accident involving one fatality occurring just moments ago in an undisclosed scene. Our own Bram Stoker is live on the scene. Come in, Bram.
Thank you, Miles. We have just arrived on the scene so that the facts are, again, very sketchy at this time.
What's going on here?
What we do know is that the incident occurred at about 4:55 p.m. It was work-related, and there was one fatality.
Do we have the name of the fatality yet?
We don't have it yet, but we're working on that, and we'll get it to you just as soon as we do.
Oh, my God! It's Harold!
Police are now cordoning off the area, clearing the area, and roping off the immediate area so that additional information will be difficult to get.
Is there any reason to believe that foul play is involved?
Actually, no. We determined that this is pretty cut and dried. The John Doe was a studio grip, for some of you people who may not know, it's kind of a glorified gopher. He was up here on the scaffolding adjusting some of the lights when he apparently had a brain aneurysm, became very dizzy, and fell to his death. There's also a possibility that he was just had severe vertigo and, again, became very dizzy and fell to his death. There is a report that he may have been drinking and just became just unstable up there and fell once again to his death. We've also noticed that there's actually a banana peel up on the scaffolding, so it's a possibility it was just a tragic accident with no intent. Some people have been saying that he was, in fact, suicidal. We don't know that for a fact. He may have just been a clumsy oaf and fell over. We're not really sure. But we do know that he came screaming down to his death.
To update viewers who may have just tuned in, an unidentified man has fell to his death at a local studio shortly before this newscast began. Police are on the scene, as is our own Bram Stoker. Bram, any updates?
Yes, in fact, we do have an update. The police have just told us that the cause of this tragic accident was the individual's head hitting the concrete floor and his brain splattering open like a water bottle.
I see.
We also have a doctor's opinion that the brain splattering around like so much Eggs Benedict didn't help the cause.
Okay, thank you for that description.
I had a local butcher come by and said it kind of looked like the inside of
a... Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Bram. We get the idea. Tell me, were there any witnesses around who may have seen the tragic plunge and, you know, maybe had a video camera rolling at the time?
Well, in fact, we do have reports there was one, and I say maybe one, eyewitness to this tragic happen. And we will try to get that from that person at this time.
Do you suppose you could get this person on the air right now for us?
Well, we will try. We will try to move over here and see if we can get a word with that individual.
All right. Our own Bram Stoker believes he has found an eyewitness, and he is approaching this person at this very moment.
Excuse me.
And he is now
Excuse
approaching
me, Bram
the...
Stoker, NSC News. Can we have a word with you?
Hi, Bram.
How are you? Bram Stoker, NSC News.
Good.
We were wondering if you happen to see, we noticed you were about 20 feet from this tragic accident. We happen to wonder if you might... might have seen what went on here.
I was 20 feet away.
That's right. And can you tell our viewers out there what occurred?
I don't know. I didn't see anything.
Okay, well, did you happen to hear anything?
No.
You didn't hear any pathetic screams?
No.
None. You didn't happen to hear a dull, sickening sound as the body crashed to the floor?
No, I'm sorry. You see, I was busy. I was preparing for our newscast.
You didn't happen to glimpse out of the corner of your eye a dead body plummeting to earth?
No. You see, I was watching the monitor ahead of me because we were about to cut to a live scene of an accident.
Okay, well, we don't seem to be able to get any information from this witness. He seems to be somewhat blind and deaf. From this grief-stricken tragedy, I'm Bram Stoker, NSC News.
And we will keep you updated on this story if any new developments occur here at NSC, the most comprehensive and concise newscast in town. More after this. ...479 sheep, 279 chickens, 9 ducks, and a golden egg.